That will be in warehouses. We have to keep it. This is what we have to provide services to the manufacturers by the wholesalers. Now go for the services to the retailer. How the wholesaler will give the assistance, will give the help to retailers. These are the manufacturer point of view. Now the retailer point of view. The wholesaler is a interlink between the wholesaler will be the interlink between the manufacturers and retailers. There is no direct relation with the customers. Yes or no? This is what we have: manufacturers, wholesalers, retailers, and customers. The wholesaler will be the interlink between the manufacturers and retailers, whereas the retailer may be the interlink with the wholesalers and the customers. So here what happened, what is that here? Manufacturer services, now go for the services of the retailer. The first one, making the goods available on time. Actually, what is the meaning of retailer? A retailer will be buy the products from the wholesaler in small quantity and sell to the customers in very small quantity. That is the what we have. It will be the retailing business, retail trade. That the activities will be taken over by a particular person will be the retailer. So here the services of wholesaler to retailer. Firstly, what is that? Making the goods available on time. Available on time. Initially, the retailers daily, day to day, 5 days after or 10 days itself, they buy these small quantities and sold to the customers in very small quantities. In between, there is no stock at all in his business, retail shop. Immediately, he may take help from the wholesaler, not the manufacturers. By initially, the wholesaler already buy the huge quantity from the manufacturers. He will be keeping their warehouses. So, in order itself, by the retailer, and wholesaler will be bring the particular goods and giving to retailer on time. Today itself, one customer in your, actually in a particular village, one Kirana general store will be there. Okay, there is some sugar or anything like, so they don't having it at present. The customer may be come to your shop. Immediately, you may call, there is no sugar at all. So customer, you say answer to you, particular customer, you may come after 1 hour, I will be arranging to you. In between time, you may call to wholesaler and I want to 1 quintal or 2 quintal of sugar. Immediately within 1 hour, you may send to me. Like that, contact will be there between the wholesaler and retailer. Immediately, the wholesaler will be send the that much of product, quantity of product like sugar will be within the 1 hour and customer may become. Then the retailer will be sold the sugar to particular customer. Making the goods available on time. This is the first service which is provided by the wholesaler to the retailer. Secondly, lending market support. This has a major point. Lending market support. We'll be providing the market support to the retailer. So actually the manufacturers are the new innovators. Different products will be produced. That will be properly giving suggestion from the receiving suggestions from the wholesaler, that through they are producing the product and that the particular products may be taken over by the wholesaler and send to or sale to the retailer. The retailer may be facing the problem if the customer may interest or may not be interest. How can I take the risk? At that time, service wholesaler will be taking providing services to market support. If there is no choice at all, again I can take back. So you have to do your work, your level best. You have to try it. If they may not buy the product from you, you may return it to me automatically, not at all problem at all to you. I may have more and more retailers. If you may not able to sell by you, some other person may be sell the particular products that will be taken over from you and that will be sent to other retailer. Don't bother about it like that. Market support also will be providing by the wholesaler to retailer. And Extending the credit facilities, yes or no here? The retailer may not pay the immediate cash and carry is not there. So, small quantity of products may be buy from the wholesaler. He may give a credit facility like 15 days or 1 month. So, in between, again you may come back. Previous amount you have to pay, and again you have to take new products with some amount of bill, and that amount of bill will be paid. Another time when you come back to the wholesaler, at that time you have to pay. That type of credit facility also providing by the wholesaler to retailer. Actually, the retailer is a small investor person. The wholesaler little bit more. Retailer will be the this much of investment only done. And wholesaler may be this much of, and manufacturers will be this much of investment will be done. So that here, retail will be less amount of investment will be there. Even also, he may maintain his business like that. So in the situation, the wholesaler will providing this credit facility. So if the maybe the retailer, once a small quantity of products may be buy by the particular retailer, immediately may not be sold away. In a situation, compulsory has to pay the amount to the wholesaler. So in that situation, the wholesaler will be providing the or extending the credit facility. Initially, for example, it is a Y product will be there. This is a new product into market. The wholesaler will be sell the goods to retailer. This is a Y, the name itself, Y, the product name. So the particular Y product is not able to sell to the customers. He may buy the 100, but actually 10 only sold away. Again, some other product to he wanted, so that he go back to the wholesaler. At that time, he asking the Y product's amount. At that time, he said, I am only sold the goods 10 only, so remaining 90 will be there. So I am not able to sell particular Y product. So in the situation, the wholesaler may be extending the credit facility on particular Y product. If you have the 90 products you have now, so again you can take the another 20 or 50, 1 month period. At that time only you can pay it. So now we have to extend, I am extending the credit to you. So don't bother about it. You can try your level best like that. Suggestion service will be provided by the wholesaler to the retailer. Then happily he may take, okay, I will do. So that's what we have the other service, which is extending the our credit facility to the retailer by the wholesaler. Sharing of specialized knowledge. Clearly sharing the specialized knowledge. How we have to attract the customers, how we are providing the pre and post services after sale, like that information properly provided to the retailer by the particular wholesaler. At that time, sharing of knowledge automatically, he may take the some techniques how to attract the customers like their situation. Further schemes or everything we have. So in the way, he may get the knowledge. Then automatically, the customers will be addicted to you, and you may sell the more and more product to the customers. So that is what another service, which is sharing of specialized knowledge regarding products or anything. If you have the new product, how can you use, you don't know, how can you sold away to the customers? So that the wholesaler will be giving the process of using the particular product, and same will be sales to your customers, and customers buy the product and they also perfectly use it. So initially you don't know, retailer don't know that how to use the particular product. Where he get particular knowledge or specialized knowledge? From the wholesaler. So that wholesaler will be providing services to the retailer. That is the sharing of the specialized knowledge. Then where is the risk bearing and risk sharing? Just now I said the newly introduced products will be there, that will be giving to the retailer. Particular retailer may not able to sell the products. So the problem will arise, the retailer facing the problem. It is sold away, not at all problem. But if it is not able to sell the product to the customers, at that time risk will be there. But particular risk will be taken over by the wholesaler. Don't bother about it. If you may not sell the product, I am taking back your product. Don't worry about it. You have to try it. It will be solved. It not at all problem. You are also earning some amount. I am also earning the some amount. So now I am having the I have lot of retailers. I am the wholesaler. have the number of retailers will be there. So retailer 1, 2, 3 like that we have. In that some area people may buy this product. For example, C is a product. Some other area persons may not interested to buy this C product. At that time, I am sold this C products to everyone. But here this one particular retailer not able to sell the C product. At that time, we take back particular C products and that will be sending to where it is easily sale. This is what we have. So automatically here the risk will be less. It will be bearing by the wholesaler. Risk will be sharing. That much of risk also will be there. If any damaged product also will be there, don't bother about by the particular retailer. He may give it back to the wholesaler and wholesaler also will be given back to the manufacturers, or like that any process will be taken place. So here the risk also will be sharing among the retailer and wholesaler. This is what we have, the services to the retailer by the wholesaler. What are the services? Making goods available on time, lending market support, extending the credit facility and sharing of specialized knowledge and risk bearing or risk sharing. This is what we have, the services of wholesaler to manufacturer and retailer. Next go for the retail trade. Here, what is the meaning of retail trade and services of retail trade?